In this video, I'm gonna try drawing a map with the cheapest pen I could possibly find. It's this one. This pen. So if you're not familiar, my name is JP Cougar. I am a professional illustrator, and my house is filled, like to the brim, with tons and tons of fancy pens that I have experimented with over the years that I've used to draw all kinds of stuff. And I've gotten to the point where I have my favorites, but even the pens that I like write notes with and we have squirreled away in drawers and stuff are usually on the nicer side just because I'm kind of a nerd about pens. I like nice pens. But instead of using one of my favorite pens to draw another map, I thought it would be fun to try and find the cheapest and crappiest pen I could and try and make a cool looking map out of that. So I went digging around and I found this pen. It's just as cheap as you can get ballpoint pen. And actually it was free because I took it from a Marriott hotel. It says so right here on the pen. So this is, you know, throwaway promotional pen that they just put in every hotel room. You know, it works for what it's intended to do, and that's just to write stuff on a sheet of paper. But can it be used to make a cool looking map? That's what I'm gonna try and find out. Maybe. We'll see. Let's go. So I'm only gonna use this crappy pen and this sheet of paper. This is just a totally regular sheet of computer paper. You can probably kind of see that it's very thin and see-through. You can kind of see the table through the paper a little bit. So the paper's cheap too. So yeah, I don't really have a solid plan for what this map is gonna be. I'm just drawing the outlines and I'm leaving some spots here and there where I think the mountains might peek up over the outlines or rivers might exit the edge of the map. But I always like to start these maps with the outline of the continent or the island or whatever. So before I start going crazy on the entire map, I'm gonna take just this small little island and experiment around a little bit to kind of get an idea of the limitations and also the benefits of this cheap, free, crappy pen. So typically I like to start with the biggest features of the map first, the stuff that like takes up the most space on the map, and then work down in scale from there. And generally that usually means like the mountains are the first thing that get put in, or I guess the mountain ranges. And while drawing these mountains, I kind of realized what the strengths of this crappy ballpoint pen are. So the really cool thing is you can very lightly make hatching pen strokes and kind of get this what's like a gray tone. You can hold the pen straight up and down and press down harder and you'll get a thicker black line, not totally uniform thick black line, but if you sort of tilt the pen and, you know, press down much more lightly, you get these sort of like thin gray lines. And I'm using those light sideways pen strokes to make a gray texture for these mountains. And it's cool because you can, you know, be real light-handed and kind of take your time with it and build up the darkness. And you're basically like shading a drawing with a crappy ballpoint pen. So once the mountains are done, I'm gonna move on to the forest, but I wanna get really detailed with these forests. So I'm drawing each and every little tree. So I'm starting with just the triangle pine trees, and then I'll move on to the round kind of trees. What kind of trees would those be? Not pine trees. And then I'll eventually add in some jungly palm trees at the bottom as well. But now that I'm working on these forests, I've quickly realized the limitations of this ballpoint pen. And I mean, well, obviously the biggest limitation for this type of pen is that like filling in large areas of black is not happening. Like, I'm not gonna do it on this map. And I guess you can do it, but it's not gonna look very good. You're basically gonna like dent the paper to get really solid black lines and then trying to fill with it. It's just not what these pens are made to do. But what I'm realizing drawing these little trees over and over again is that this pen isn't actually that accurate. What makes it inaccurate, I think, is that I don't really know what side of the tip the ink is gonna come out of. And you know, when you look at the pen, you would think like, oh, that shouldn't really matter. But then when you get into drawing these teeny tiny little trees, you know, or if you're trying to draw a circle where the start of the circle and the end of the circle line up, when you get this small, you know, if the line is coming out of the top of the pen and then it circles back around and it's ends up coming out of the bottom of the pen, then your line isn't gonna match up. So when you zoom out, it's gonna look fine, but as I'm doing this, I'm noticing that this pen like isn't accurate, which is such a weird thing to say, but that's what I'm noticing. Also, the pen kind of like clogs up really easily, so you have to kind of rotate it in your hand to get it to like unclog a little bit. You know, is it a super big deal? Probably not, but it is it's a crappy pen, so it clogs up. So despite all of the limitations of this pen, I'm actually having a lot of fun making this map, drawing in all the details like the sand dunes and this desert. You know, it's fun using a new tool to draw something that you've drawn a bunch before, so you can really focus on experimenting with the tool. And it's also fun to use the tool to try and draw something new, but draw it in a way that lends itself to this tool. So like this radioactive mist I have going up at the top, I want it to be this kind of wispy, you know, shroud of mystery that is covering the whole top part of the map. And getting to use this pen to fill in those details is just, it's fun. Okay, so I've drawn all the major landmarks of the map, but one thing I always like to have on my maps is some sort of like centerpiece, or maybe not centerpiece, in this case a centerpiece, but some sort of like, you know, this is a fantasy map, some like fantastical element that makes you wonder and want to explore. And I just finished listening to the book The Fifth Season by N.K. Jemisin, and awesome fantasy book. And there's these mysterious obelisks in there that are these like ancient buildings that it's not quite clear what they are. And so I thought that would be a fun thing to stick in the middle of this map, some crazy obelisk with a giant floating orb that looks like it crash landed onto this map. So one thing that always happens to me as I'm working on these maps is I get so into all of the little details and I focus on one little area and then focus on the next area and then fill up the whole map. Once I take a step back and zoom out, I realize that things start to sort of blend together. So there's always a step in the process where I have to kind of make things pop a little bit, make things stand out so the map is easier to look at. So what I'm doing here is just going around the outside of the island where the land meets the water and making the line a little bit thicker. Now I wish this was as easy as just drawing another line next to it, but with this pen you kind of have to like scribble in this solid black line. And really all this does is just makes the islands and stuff pop off the map a little bit. It almost makes it look like they're like raising up out of the empty space that is the water. You know, at first I thought that I was going to do some sort of cool texture with the pen to make the waves, but I sort of second guessed myself and went with the kind of traditional just broken outline that goes around the outside of the continent and the islands. Maybe there would have been a cooler way to do this, but you know, experimenting with this pen has me a little more cautious than usual. I'm not as comfortable even though I've done this whole drawing, and I definitely don't want to screw up this map at this late stage in the drawing. So simple squiggly line water is what I'm doing. So I think the map is looking pretty good, but there is this very large negative space, big empty space, and I think it needs a big compass rose to kind of bring the whole composition together. Now, drawing compass roses are extremely easy to mess up because they kind of have to be at the right angle. They actually literally have to be a right angle. Four right angles, in fact. So I'm gonna break the rules and I'm gonna use a pencil and a ruler to measure it all out. But actually, you know what? I went and grabbed my Shovel Knight amiibo and a little tube from like this roll of labels, and I'm using those to trace the circle for this compass rose. And that gets to the entire point of this video, and that is you don't need fancy tools and stuff to make fun, cool drawings. You can totally just use whatever you have laying around, a free pen that you got from a hotel, your Shovel Knight amiibo, and some little piece of cardboard to draw a circle. You know, the point of drawing this stuff is to have fun and experiment and try and make something that you think looks cool. And it's really surprising how much the limitations of your tools, on one hand, they can sort of restrict your creativity, but on the other hand, that restriction forces your brain to sort of problem solve and figure out how to make the thing you want to make with the tool that you're using. And I think that is a super fun puzzle to solve or challenge to tackle. And really the only way to figure out what kind of tools you like to use is to experiment and play with different things and figure out what works best for what you're trying to do. So yeah, there it is, the finished map. Let me know in the comments if you think I was successful drawing a map with this pen. I think it turned out pretty good, and I'm at least surprised with how it turned out. And really, I just had a bunch of fun making it, and that is the important thing. So if you're interested in learning how to draw fantasy maps, I got tons of other videos that cover all kinds of different types of maps and how to draw mountains and forests and all kinds of stuff. Definitely check those out if you're looking to learn a little bit more about drawing fantasy maps. If you enjoyed this video and would like to support the channel, hit me with the subscribe, leave a like, all that stuff. You can also join my Patreon, where every month I release a new tabletop role-playing game adventure in zine form, like this one right here, the Plumwax Kobolds just came out last month. And if you end up drawing a map with a crappy pen, I would love, love, love to see it. I always enjoy seeing what you all make. It really, really motivates me to keep working on these videos. Let me know what you think of my ballpoint pen map in the comments. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. See ya!